Mr. Fajar, you can please open the class. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Hello, everybody. Hi. Ini kelompok 4 ya yang kita presentasi. Itu kelompok saya. Untuk teman yang sudah bergabung, baru ada Mas Raka. Tadi Mas Samsul sudah saya kontak, tapi masih dalam perjalanan. Ini Pak, anggapnya lagi ada kerjaan atau sibuk. Ini langsung saya mulai aja untuk presentasinya. Teman-teman, Pak, Angga.
Okay, please, Mr. Fajar. For group 4, yeah? 3, group 4. Okay, what times today? What is the title for today?
Singular and plural possessive nouns and proper noun and common noun.
Okay, all right. Okay, please.
Wait, I open the presentation.
All right.
Yang ngerjainnya juga masih ada di dorong sekarang, Pak. Yang ngerjainnya di dorong. Kalau di bawah rija, kalau di atas yang itu.
Sekarang
di
mana?
Masih di pemetaan. Jadi
pemetaan rija. Masih lama ya, Pak? Ya. Kalau saya berkat ya.
Apa
kemarin
yang
itu okay. Good evening everybody.
Bisa agak cepat Pak, kalau di atas bagian pengumumannya
untuk my group anggota yang hadir baru
masih punya tarik nggak di situ
baru saya sama Mas Raka. Mas Raka hadir
juga nih. Soalnya yang terakhir yang Avalia itu
belum Mas Raka.
Itu yang banyak kupasakan, Pak, yang sebelum dia pensiun. Makanya Andi ada sanksi juga, Pak.
Baik, ini saya mulai dahulu untuk materi singular and plural, possessive noun, and proper noun,
siap,
and common noun. Ya. What is possessive noun? Possessive noun is a noun that I'm or but
noun.
Process of something. In most cases for singular nouns, so that possession we add an apostrophe. E plus C S for polar nouns we simply add an apostrophe except for those few polar nouns that do not end in As example, the cars run safe. At a possessive noun is car. Karena as. Di sini sudah ada jelasan apostrofnya plus s. Untuk car-nya itu sebagai astrop. Astropnya s itu untuk tambahannya. Bartkowski's book untuk Bartkowski's ini sebagai possessive noun-nya. Selanjutnya ada baby's sauce, baby's sebagai possessive noun-nya. Lemon acidity, lemon's possessive noun. Of is of-nya sebagai possessive noun-nya. Next.
Jadi possessive noun itu apa, Mas?
Possessive noun kalau di singkat itu yang pertambahan s, Pak. Astrop-nya.
Mm-hmm. Maknanya?
Possessive something, sesuatu yang tambahkan, Pak.
Really? A possessive noun is a noun that names who or what owns has a possession of something. Ayo, artinya apa itu? Saja. Possessive noun adalah kata benda yang mana names who or what owns. Nah, orang memiliki has possession of something, dia memiliki sesuatu gitu. Seorang memiliki sesuatu. Jadi noun yang menunjukkan kepemilikan gitu. That's possessive noun. Get it? Kayak the car ini kan, car itu kan noun kan?
Iya. Yeah.
Karena ditambah apostrophe sama s jadinya cars. Artinya s itu menunjukkan a possession of something. Rasa memiliki apa? Pemilikan kepada memiliki rasa kepemilikan, bukan rasa kepemilikan sih, menunjukkan kepemilikan kepada car tersebut gitu. The car's front seat. Bartkowski's book, baby shoes, sepatunya baby apa bayi gitu kan. Lemon's acidity. Acidity apa, punya siapa? Rasanya acidity itu apa, dari mana gitu, punyanya siapa, ternyata punyanya apa, rasa apa, ternyata rasanya lemon tuh acidity. Owl's eyes. Owl's itu kan elang ya, mata, eyes mata. Owl's eyes matanya elang atau mata elang. That's kepemilikan of something, pada sesuatu gitu. Oke, okay? Please next. The other can please turn on your camera ya, jangan cuma Mr. Fajar dan Mr. siapa nih? Mr. Topan doang yang nyalain kamera. That's your Mr. Topan. Sorry.
Foto itu, Pak.
So, okay. So sorry.
Next. Okay. Trick Mister.
Oh. Oke. Okay. Okay, please continue, Mr. Bajar.
Yes, possessive nouns, forming roles-nya. When creating the possessive form of nouns, there are 5 simple rules as follow. Jadi ada 5 rules untuk kita ikuti. Step 1. Making singular noun possessive. Step 2, making plural nouns possessive. Step 3, indicating possession when the nouns are joined together. Step 4, indicating possessive possession when the nouns are joined and ownership is separate five, making happy hinet, happy not, or compound nouns possessive. Di sini untuk cara-cara simpelnya. Next. Making singular. Making singular nouns possessive. If a singular noun adds s, tambahan s kepemilikan s-nya, the grills, grills, hands were cepet, cepet.
The grills ya. The girls.
The girls.
Mm-hmm.
Hands were
hands. Cepet. The girls hand. The girls hand.
Were cepet by the cold.
By the cold. Okay.
Singularnya, singular girls, singular nouns, and next. The cat's toe, the cat's tie was missing.
Yeah,
even
yeah.
If the singular noun is a proper noun, I, he, a name, at s. Richard, attempt to solve the problem we reward. If name ending is s, you can add her at an apostrophe plus s, or just an apostrophe. The first option is more common when pronouncing a possessive name. We add the sound / z / to the end of the name. Carlos car of Carlos car.
Mana itu? Charles, bukan Carlos.
Charles.
Charles.
Charles. Charles. Charles car. Or
Charles car.
Chambers house.
Mm-hmm.
Or Chambers house. Cheers, exam, or cheers, exam.
So what is the difference, Mr. Fajar, between apostrophe after S, after the first S, and apostrophe after the first S, I mean, there are two S here. There are double S, right? There is double S there. Charles, the first example for Charles. Charles car. There is after E, there is S, and then apostrophe, and then S. Or Charles, and there is one S. S, and then apostrophe. What is the difference between double S, that there is apostrophe and there is no double S, but there is apostrophe after S. Bedanya apa sih? Kalau di maknanya sama enggak?
Sama, Pak.
Mm-hmm. The first option is more common. When pronouncing a possessive name, we add the sounds to the end of the name. Opsi pertama itu adalah paling banyak pakai sama orang gitu ya. Paling banyak digunakan ya. Charles. Jadi ada Charles itu kan nama orang, kemudian ditambahkan apostrophe sama s, ya. bila tidak mau ditambahkan apostrof, apa tidak mau tambahkan s, jadi cuma apostrof doang. Ya, jadi ya. Thank you. Yuk, see you tomorrow. Ya.
Mantap.
Sorry. Sorry. Iklan sedikit ya. So here, Charles card, that Charles double L, and Charles only one S. It means Charles, the S here is part of the name, yeah. Charles is part of the name. This here. The second or, yeah. The second example, Charles card, there are double S here. And then, or Charles card. Charles card here is, the S is part of the name, and there is apostrophe. But the common one is, the common use by the people around the world is, kalau untuk kepemilikan ya, untuk kepemilikan maka ditambah s setelah nama, not only apostrophe but there is s after that. Okay, so the meaning is same. Okay, please continue.
And yang di stack tuh making plural nouns.
Stage. All right. It's okay.
Stage two. Making plural nouns possessive. If a noun is plural, in, from, and ends in, an, s, at, an, astrop, only. When the table, legs were all wobbly and need repaired. Two, series stone can break you that if you are not careful. Three, people are prepared to pay high price for designer clothes. If a plural noun not an in s at s.
Mr. Fajar, you are as a presenter. I permit first to turn off my camera because I have something to do. Just 5 minutes, okay? Please continue and control your friends. Yeah.
Okay.
Just 5 minutes. Please continue.
Okay. Everybody, kita next. Kita every.
Yes.
Stage three, indicating possession when two nouns are joined together. If there is joint possession, is the correct possessive for only the possessive close to the nouns. One, clean on and course combine was successful. Two, I did come Mr. and Mrs. Smith's meeting. Three, Carol Carol and Susan's car is out of gasoline. Gasoline. Next. Indicating possessive possession when two nouns are joined and ownership is paired. If there is a separate possession of the same nouns, use the correct possessive form for each word.
If you have any question to Mr. Fajar, if you have any question to Mr. Fajar or another presenter, please ask, don't be silent. If you don't understand what Mr. Fajar and friends presentation, please ask. Jangan sampai diam saja if you do not understand. All right?
All right.
Okay. So whose turn now? Whose turn now?
Whose turn now?
Giliran siapa sekarang?
Ini saya, Pak. Ini satu slide. Terus
nanti. Oh, so still Mr. Fajar's part. Okay.
Susan's and Pat's books are full of useful information. Susan and Pat to the cars and the vehicles owner called speak French perfectly.
That's it.
Suaranya merupakan
I think the chat is mine. I think the chat is mine. Eventually, Mr. Fajar's chat. Yeah. Oh my God. I want your IG actually, Mr. Fajar.
Oh my God.
Okay, please. So di sini ya, Mr. Fajar tadi bilang, if there is spirit possession of the same noun, use the correct possessive form for each word. Formnya sama saja ya, after name there is apostrophe and then s. There are two possession here, Susan and Beth. Ya. Ada dua kepemilikan ya, punya Susan sama punya Beth, dan juga di sini punyanya cars, punyanya mobil sama punyanya bicycles, motor ya, or motor sepeda. So after the name car or after the noun Susan and or noun Beth, we have to put apostrophe and then s after that. Okay, the form is same. Okay. Okay, please.
Okay. Next slide.
Next slide.
Continue
by
Mr. Raka.
Mr. Raka.
Ready.
Mr. Raka. Time is your. Mr. Raka is ready actually. And I just saw his head. His hair. His hair and his head.
Lift. Nah. Okay. Mr. Raka. Silakan. Enggak ada suaranya, Mas. Suaranya nggak masuk, Mas. Baik, continue by Mr. Ridwan. Ridwan Wahyu. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay.
Making happiness or component nouns possessive. With happiness or component nouns, use the correct possessive from the for the words close
to the noun. Mr. Ridwan, please turn on your camera.
Avoid possessive with component plurals. 1. My daughter-in-law gave in a diamond necklace. 2. The English teacher method is very effective. 3. Your neighbor letter carries job in more difficult than you imagine. Singular and plural possessive nouns image. Possessive nouns. A possessive noun shows the a person or an animal own or has something. Singular nouns. If it's a common noun, it's dog house, book words, girls dolls, bird chicks, car engine, sister room. Plural nouns. If the noun ends in ed, dog house, book words, girls dolls, bird chicks. If the noun doesn't end in s ed, make cheese, woman's hat.
Got it, everyone? You got it?
If are there any question?
It's not. Is there any question? No questions. Okay, please continue.
Nothing, guys. Okay, next slide.
What is singular possessive nouns? A singular possessive noun is a singular noun the show of an ownership. Maksudnya, singular possessive nouns adalah singular nouns, kata benda yang tunggal yang menunjukkan kepemilikan. The best way to make single possessive nouns. Two around singular possessive nouns, add an approps sign and the letter in the singular nouns. Example, the word sister. The word sister, a singular noun, you create a singular possessive noun from, we add a prop and after the final letter. Then, the singular possessive noun is sister.
Any question, guys? Nothing? Okay, next slide.
Example. Sister, idea is the better than mine. My child, dog. The mouse, cat. Someone, memories. Dog, house.
Okay, please, next.
What is plural possessive nouns? A plural possessive nouns is plural nouns the sound ownership. Maksudnya, plural possessive nouns adalah plural nouns kata benda jamak yang menunjukkan kepemilikan.
Mas Raka, are you?
Belum gabung.
Oke, okay. Mas Ridwan, continue slide.
Halo. Kok ada suaranya? Halo, ada suaranya enggak?
Ada.
Ada. Oke, okay, Mas Raka. Silakan dilanjut. Nanti. Halo, Mas Raka. Oke. Okay. Light. Jaringan light. Lag. Mas Rafi? Mas Rafi. Mas Ridwan? Next slide, please.
The best way to make plural possessive nouns. The method is A. If the plural nouns and ins at a postcard. If the last letter is not, then add the apostrophe and the letters.
Okay. My
example with the ends. Trucks is a plural noun. To make it into possessive nouns from trucks. Example sentence using plural possessive nouns. Truck wheels are big. The N with letters. Woman is plural nouns ending alter than the letters. To make a plural possessive nouns, woman sauce. Example of sentence. The woman's socks are expensive.
Okay. Any question, guys? Nothing? Okay, next slide. Coming nouns. Saya lanjutkan, Mas. Ini karena Mas Raganya masih bermasalah audionya. Baik. Common nouns. What is common nouns? Common nouns are words used to name general items rather than specific nouns. Go into your living room. What do you see? I lamp. Tire. Just TV, window, painting, pillow, candle, all of these items are named using common nouns. Common nouns are everywhere and you use them all the time. Even if you don't release it wherever you go, you have been at least one common noun straight closet, bedroom, school, mall, gas station.
Mas Fajar. School itu apa? School
nasi, Pak. Nasi.
School.
Bakul. Yeah. Aku duwe school sak bakul.
Yang lain nggak ngerti, Pak. Nanti, Pak, bahasanya.
Oke, please.
Sekul itu bahasa Jawa. Oke, guys, next. Sekul. Mall, gas station, living room, all of this place are things, and this they are common nouns. Okay, next slide. Example. I have a red car. The girl is drinking milk. The man is playing a kid in a park.
Can you back to the previous slide? What is common noun? Common noun are words used to the name to name general item rather than specific one. Go into your living room. What do you see? Lamp, chair, couch, TV, window, painting, willow, candle. All of these items are name used common nouns. Di sini common noun adalah kata benda yang biasa orang menggunakannya. Ya, common ya, dia sudah common. Lamp is lampu ya. Semua orang juga tahu.
Lampu.
Iya. Yeah.
Tosh.
Chair, kursi, couch, TV, window, painting, pillow. That's common noun. So common nouns here are everywhere. Common noun itu ada di mana-mana. And you use them all the time. Dan kamu menggunakan mereka tuh apa? Sepanjang waktu, all the time. Ya. Yeah.
Always same.
Even if you don't realize it. Walaupun kamu kadang tidak sadari itu kalau kamu tuh menggunakan noun itu sendiri. Ya. Yeah. Kayak saat ini kamu menggunakan laptop. Laptop is noun, right?
Yes.
Happy handphone is noun.
Windows 10.
That's a noun. Windows 10. Sombongnya. Wherever you go, you'll find at least one common noun. Kemana pun kamu pergi, kamu akan menemui, walaupun itu adalah satu noun, common noun. It's like street, closet, bathroom, school, mall, gas station, living room, all of these places are things, and those they are common nouns. Mereka semua itu adalah kamar semuanya, jalan, closet, kamar mandi, bedroom, kamar tidur, school, sekolah, shop, kampus, mall, gas station, living room, ruang tamu, all of these places are things. Mereka semua itu benda gitu. Semua tempat itu adalah benda, are thing, which is noun. Okay, please, Mr. Rifki. All of these places are things, and those they are common noun. Dan mereka itu adalah common noun. Maka, next slide, coba. Maka ketika di contohnya, here. Please, next slide.
I have a red car.
I have a red car. Car is common noun, right? The girl is common, ya. Yeah. Sekeliling kita nggak mungkin nggak ada perempuan. Pasti ada perempuan. The man also. Of course, selalu ada. We are a man, right? We are a man.
Ada. My office not girls.
There is no girls in the office. But you all are a man, right? That's common noun. He's flying a kite in the park. Kite is also common noun. Park also common noun. Okay, that's common noun. Wherever you go, wherever we sit, wherever we are going to go, we will find it, the common noun. Even only one common noun. Okay, please, next.
Okay. Proper nouns. Proper nouns. What is proper nouns? Proper nouns have two distinct features. They name specific one of a kit items.
Items.
Items. And they begin with capital letters. No matter where they occur.
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 Mm-hmm.
Within
a sentence.
Within a sentence. Here we I take a closer.
We will
take a closer look at proper nouns.
Mm-hmm.
Provide proper noun example and help you learn how to use a proper noun the right way. Okay, please. Example. Okay, all right.
Uh-huh.
I have a Ferrari car.
Uh-huh.
Ferrari is a capital. Okay, next. Honey and Nada are playing with the snow.
Uh-huh.
Honey is a people, always a capital name. In awal dan di manapun harus menggunakan kapital. Next.
Jadi coba kembali ke sebelumnya. The previous slide. Please, the previous slide. In this, we have Mr. Fajar showed the slide about proper noun. So what is proper noun? Proper noun have two distinct features. The name specific one of kind items and they begin with capital letters. Jadi ada dua ciri ya daripada proper nouns. Yang pertama dia itu adalah nama dari sebuah benda ya. Dia nama daripada sebuah benda, kind of name of specific noun ya, one of kind items. And they begin with capital letters. Dan dia akan dimulai oleh capital letters. Capital letter itu huruf besar. Ya? No matter where they occur within a sentence. Walaupun dimanapun dia muncul di dalam sebuah kalimat, dia akan diawali dengan capital letter. Oke, coba lihat contohnya. Nah, di sini ada car. Ya. Common noun-nya itu adalah car. Car-nya itu common noun. But here, common noun ya karena banyak kan. So Ferrari here is a specific ya. Specific items of car. Ya enggak? Item spesifiknya daripada mobil itu adalah Ferrari, ada Nissan ya, ada lain-lain gitu kan. I have a Ferrari car. Ya di sini Ferrari-nya di capital letter. Even he is in the subject. Honey and Nada are playing with the snow. Di sini Honey dan Nada ini adalah woman, right? Woman is common noun. So here we talk about proper noun. Proper noun is a part of common noun, which is Honey and Nada. Nah, Honey and Nada is a woman, are playing with the snow. Spesifik ya, jadi nama orang lebih ke spesifik lagi itu. So here also we are in Albasair private school. Private school. School that's noun karena sudah ada namanya. Namanya adalah Albasair private school.
Sure.
Maka Albasairnya also capital letter. So that's like ITTS. ITTS itu kan Institut Teknologi Tangerang Selatan. Itu teknologi.
BTS.
ITTS itu kan part of university ya, part of sekolah tinggi, part of ya sekolah after SMA lah. Ya kan? Tapi karena dia sudah dinamakan maka jadi specific ya, specific school, specific college. That's ITS and UMT and another college. Another name of college. Okay, please next. Habis?
Yes.
Maghrib.
Maghrib. Any question for group 4?
Any question, guys? Nothing.
You can close the presentations.
Okay. Thank you everybody, Pak Aga.
So after this we continue to group 5, yeah.
Group 5.
Okay. Mr. Atta, Mr. Misbah, Aldi, Andrian plus Eka.
File-nya tadi udah tak kirim Jabri ya, Pak?
Reza hadir.
Berapa teman-teman grup per tidak hadir, Pak? Cuma saya, Ridwan, Mas Kaka. Tadi,
Salsa tadi kalau nggak salah izin deh.
Oh iya, jadi saya Jabri nggak ada respon.
Mungkin sudah melupakanmu, Mas. Oke, grup 5 Atta Esa ada Mas Tata. Are you ready to present? Maaf Pak, Raka nggak ada audionya karena ada masalah Pak di audionya. Oke, okay. I can read your part. Mr. Samsul? No. Misbahuddin. Mr. Misbah? Nothing. Aldi S. Present. Aldi Setian. Okay, that's a cat. A cat, yeah.
Cat.
That's a cat. Mr. Aldi S. Cat, yeah. Andrian. Mr. Mrs. Nurul, yeah.
Hadir.
Oh, tidur dia, Mas.
Hadir.
Kok lemes gitu? Pantesan dari tadi nggak on cam.
Aduh. Terus.
Ini sempat on cam ya.
Eka Praset ya.
Itu udah dari habis UTS nggak pernah hadir.
Oh, nggak pernah ada lagi ya. Jadi Eka Praset sama Ridwan beda ya. Oke, okay, Mr. Atta and friend, time is yours. Jadi, ada berapa slide, Mas Atta? How many slide do you have?
5 minutes. 5 minutes.
Loh, kok ngilang?
15, Pak.
15. You can present only 5 slide maybe. 5 or 6 slide. We continue next meeting. Okay, please, time is yours.
Rule in writing number. How do you expect number your writing? When do you use equal digits? And when do you write out the number in word? Ever. That is 9. Jadi artinya 9 ya. 10 dan 10. Sorry. Number one, number versus numeral. Resting phrase. What is the difference between a number and numeral? A number is an abstract concept. Well, a numeral is a symbol used to express the number 3. And 3 are all symbol used to express the same number of the concept of presence. One can say that the difference between a number and its plural is like the difference between a person and her name. Number two spells small number four. The small number such as world's number small that 10 so be set out. That's one rule you can count on. If you don't spell number of it will look like you're sending an instant message and you want to be more formal. Number three, no other standard rule. Expert don't always agree on other rules. Some experts say that anyone what number solve that to what number solve the experts in people. That is, they say you solve it. Or 12 or 20, but not 24. Number four, use the comma. In English, the comma is used a thousand separator and the 30 as a decimal separator. To make large number, letter two. So where the seas of Alaska as 971 square miles instead of 571 square miles. In continental Euro, the opposite is to Euro, they used to spot part number, and the comma is used for decimal. Finally, the international system of units, or SE, recommended as shall be used to spell group of three digits. And both the comma and the period result they use on to denote decimal. The comma is part of us, you know. Number five, don't start a standard numeral. Like it was 4 and 7 years ago, but 4 and 7 years ago. That means you might have to revise some system and just copy and the first day instead of copy sort the first day. In number six, centauris and decades sort be spelled out. Use the eclipse or 9-10 centauri. Number seven, presents and receipts. With everyday reading and receipts, you can use it like 4% of the children or add 2 cups of breads. Informal reading. Whenever you saw spell the letters are like 12% of the player. Number eight, if the number is small or assistant, spell it out. But number of a million are written as a numeral plus a word. Use for 100 million people. Of about 400 people spend Spanish if you using the exact number you do that out of course. And the last number then two number next to each other. Then because fishing you want second one two three. So write on the last numeral like a 73 year old. And then ordinal number and quantity. Don't say he was my first to love, but rather he was my first to love. Be consistent within the same system. If my teacher has been a student, she also has a past student. Not take then a past student. And the next is basic columns. Masih enggak apa ini, Pak?
So numbers already done, already presented by Mr. Acha. So for the columns, it should be presented by Mr. Atta's friends. Siapa temannya yang hadir?
I am
Aldia. Sure. Yes, okay. Please, Mr. Aldi, time is yours.
Okay, thank you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Basic columns. The columns look like a period sitting on top of another period. A column is used after an independent clause to direct readers' attention to something that follows, like a list, a quote, an example, or explanation. For example, the column website announced the new Dean Shara Rivera. The Toyota period comes is four colors, red, blue, orange, or black. Mark Twain said it best when it doubt, tell the truth. However, if the introductory clause is independent, generally we don't use colon.
So in this sentence, in this industry example, I mean, where is the colons? Where is the colons, Mr.? Colons-nya itu ada di mana itu? In this example, the college website announced the new dean, Shara Rivera. D-nya itu adalah Shara Rivera. So, in this sentence, where is the colons? Mr. Aldi, where? Where is the column? That's the question, right?
Yeah.
Mm-mm. So where is the column? So what is mean by the column? Column itu titik dua, bukan sih?
Yeah.
That's the column. So my question is where is the column? Di mana column-nya? Ternyata column-nya itu after Dean here. After then his column Shara Rivera. Jadi dia itu menghubungkan Shara Rivera ini dengan new dean ini. New dean-nya siapa? Adalah Shara Rivera. The Toyota Prius comes in four colors. The Toyota Prius itu datang dengan empat warna katanya di sini. Warnanya apa aja? Di sini disebutkan red, blue, orange, or black. Red, blue, orange, or black ini adalah warna dari Toyota Prius, kayak gitu. Mark Twain said it best. Mark Twain said it best. Titik dua. When it doubt, tell the truth. When it doubt, tell the truth. Nah, artinya di sini when it doubt, tell the truth itu adalah perkataan daripada Twain. yeah, Mark Twain. Oke. Jadi dia kembali kepada subjeknya itu sendiri. Oke, please, Mister, continue. However,
if the introductory clause independent, generally we don't use a color. For example, the Toyota Prius come in red, blue, orange, and black. The first letter following a colon is capitalized only if the word is a proper noun, the beginning of a quote, or the beginning of a sentence. Otherwise, do not capitalize a word that follow a colon.
Okay, please, Tony. Next slide.
Basic dash. A dash is a long line between words. Use the shape of a phrase of for emphasis. You can enclose the between two dash or just use one dash to set off a parish from the beginning or the end of the sentence. For example, I love movies about other countries such as Slumdog Millionaire and Roman. The new students, Oliver, Diego, and Natasha still need to buy their textbooks. Unless you have a good reason for using dash, avoid it using dash as create a choppy feel and generally other punctuation marks work equally well. For example, commas would replace the dash in two sentences above.
Then next,
teman lainnya Pak, kasihan.
Ada yang lain lagi? Ada yang hadir? Kita tunggu minggu depan kalau dia nggak ada hari ini. Coba siapa aja tadi?
Temannya. Mas Ardian mungkin.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Adrian ada enggak? Kalau enggak ada ya sudah. Kita stop dulu sampai sini. We continue next meeting.
Tanggung tinggal
4 slide ya? Tinggal 4 slide.
Tinggal 4 enggak? 1 2 3. 4.
Lanjut.
Lanjut wes. Miss Bahudin? Enggak ada. Eka Prasetya. Yang buat slide siapa nih?
Saya, Pak.
Mister Rata ya? Oke. RK Prasetya enggak ada. Mana slide yang mau dia... When to use them? This one.
Mas Adi, monggo dibantu.
Mas Adi, please.
Okay. When to use them? Nouns are people, place or things, people, place, and things can all either perform action or receive action that are performed by someone else. In grammar, something that performs an action is called a subject. Where something the receive an action is called an object. Pronouns can replace noun in sentence, which is useful when you want to avoid using the same word several times in the same sentence. Like nouns, pronouns can also be subject or object. English has specific pronouns to each of these grammatical cases. Like they and them. These pronouns mean almost exactly the same thing, but are not incredible, interchangeable. Science on the is science. One is a subject, object pronoun, and the other a subject pronoun. What is the difference between they and them? And this was, I will compare they versus them. I will show you example sentence for each of this word, so you can see them in context. When to use they? Is they a pronoun? Yes, they is a pronoun. Especially is a third person plural subject pronoun. It refers to a group of two or more people. They in non-gendered. Gendered. It can refer to any combination of more than two people. For example, I tried to tell the Cleveland fans that their team would lose, but they won't listen. After you go on a no first date with different people, they all start to blend together. All the same time, they talk up their own digital cups and well partnership with an investment in digital companies. The Wall Street Journal. As mentioned above, pronoun replaced noun in sentence. They is a subject pronoun, so it replaced the subject of a sentence. When to use them? Is a pronoun? Yes, it's a pronoun. Especially a third person plural subject pronoun. Like they is referred to a group of more than two people. It is no gendered as well. Unlike they, however, them is a object pronoun. It replaces nouns that are the subject, subject, the sentence. See the example below. The British folk valiantly while arrow rained down on them from the French castle. Jennifer and Clara become annoyed when Angus tries to do. To their work from them. When we always yell to our children, once we rob them of the opportunity to find solution by adapting when they already have the New Year pass. In the first example, them replace the British as the object of the verb rain. In the second example, them replace Jennifer and Kala as an object of the verb tries. Trick to remember the difference. Them and they are both third person pronouns. Knowing which one to use is not always easy if you aren't well practiced in English writing, but this mnemonic device will help you. So let's go over a trick to remember them. Versus they. Them is an object pronoun. They is a subject pronoun. Them and him another object pronoun, but both and in him. Letter M. This third letter can be your clue. Then them should be used as the object in sentence. Thank you very much for your participation. For the last session, allow me and the team to thank you for this time. Hope you useful for you all, for all of us. Thank you very much.
Give applause for them.
Aku tadi enggak ya, Pak.
Thank you. Kelompok Mas Atta spesial loh.
Thank you.
Dapat applause.
Berdua ini Pak bentar.
Only 2%, 3% right? Yeah. Okay. Thank you for all of you for the presenter from group 4 and group 5 today. So for the next meeting, we're gonna talk about, I mean, we're going to discuss about tenses, right? That's the basic one for learning English. Okay, next one. Okay, today, after this, we're going to absent first.
Present, sir.
No, I didn't call your name. From system information system. Fahrur Rahim?
Nothing.
Nothing. Kalau ada bilang ada Mas Fajar ya, soalnya enggak saya share screen. Muhammad Ridwan Wahyu Al-Yasin, of course nothing.
Prison.
Prison. Prison.
Yes. Tadi presentasi sama saya, Pak. Ini.
Oh. Ridwan Wahyu Al-Yasin. Kemarin kemana Mas? Minggu kemarin?
Kerja Pak. Banyak kerjaan lagi, banyak kerjaan.
Masya Allah, Masya Allah. Barokah, barokah.
Iya.
Kabarin, kabarin. Jangan lupa aja.
Iya Pak.
Ahmad Ulinuha.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Pak.
Ya. Yeah.
Izin left duluan Pak, mau meeting saya Pak.
Oke, okay, please, please, please Mas, please.
Monggo, monggo, monggo.
Monggo, monggo. Agus Muhammad Soleh, nothing. Andida Adinda Balkis, Adinda Lutia Balkis. Oke. Okay.
Adinda Lutia Balkis.
Belum belum di, belum selesai dipanggil namanya sudah.
Bapaknya grogi lagian.
Keringetan saya coba.
Mas Pajar langsung salting Mas Pajar.
Mas Pajar. Terus kalah pamor karo Pajar aku.
Ah.
Beli beli.
Terus siapa lagi nih? Muhammad Soleh. Ah, ini nih juragannya di sini nih.
Hadir, sir.
Oh, hadir.
Yo.
Mana? Allah. Besok hadir apa ikut conference enggak?
Ya, insyaallah sih hanya menyiapkan saja.
Kalau bisa ikut ya.
Insyaallah.
Kalau dan yang lain-lain juga kayak Miss Nurul, Mr. Reza.
Pasti.
Mr. Nurul pasti ikut ya?
Pasti.
Pasti ikut kan? Kan jadi host. Bukannya jadi host, Miss?
Enggak. Nurul udah jadi host satu, Pak.
Aduh, tadinya mau tak usulin jadi host ya. Dari karyawan. Nggak
bisa ngomong nanti.
Dari karyawan Nurul, dari apa? Dari reguler itu siapa? Laude ya. Rekomendasi.
Pak. Apa giliran aja, Pak?
Warasa host ya. Besok engko tak gawe conference dhewe wis. Nadia, siapa nih? Adrian Satria Karim, nothing.
Nothing.
Rahmat. Nothing, 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 nothing.
I'm hungry.
Okay, yeah, me too, me too, me too. Kenapa kelas pagi itu sudah 14 pertemuan, kelas sore kok masih 13 ya?
Woi,
kebut Pak, kebut.
Saya kok bingung.
Ayo kebut.
Kita kena libur pas itu paling, Pak.
Kapan?
Kapan ya? Tanggal 1 kita tanggal tanggal 1 apa sih?
Kan semua sama kan?
Iya sih. Heeh deh.
Maybe I was wrong. Abdullah Huzaifi?
Hadir Pak.
Oke. Okay. Rifki Algi Fauzan, nothing ya. Muhammad Misbahuddin, nothing. Misbahuddin, nothing. Ya yeah, nothing.
Nothing.
Reza Nur Arifin.
Present sir.
Alright. Reza. Leonis Firdaus.
Nothing.
Ahmad Fauzi.
Nothing.
Topan Firdaus.
Present.
Alright. Fadli Marcelo Manalu. I didn't see Mr. Marcelo, Fadli. Gak ada ya?
Nothing.
Oke. Okay. Atta Esa Nugraha. Doni Wahyudi.
Hadir.
Oh, iya ya, aduh. Singgih Prasetyo. Masih izin siapa yang tadi izin? Wait a minute.
Saya itu Pak tadi
Salsa ya? And no one. Only Salsa. Singgi? Nggak ada ya. Fajar Kurniadi? Hadir. Ridwan Prasetya?
Hadir, Pak.
Mr. Ridwan, kemarin kemana?
Itu, kemarin, Pak. Tumbang.
Ura, yuk. Ngarang.
Kemana?
Kemarin hadir, cuma nggak sampai selesai itu, Pak. Mati listrik.
Oh, gitu. Iya, iya, iya. Ya. Rifki Setiawan?
Hadir, okay. Pak.
Hadir.
Wah, wedding ngantuk. Wah.
Eka Prasetya Romadoni? Nothing. Oke.
Baju kok.
Wendy Nur Hermansyah.
Hadir, Pak.
Tegar Muhammad Rifki. Tegar. Enggak pernah alpa loh dia nih. Mana dia?
Lu cewek.
Oh, iya. Orangnya kemana? Aldi Setiawan?
Legend saya hadir.
Fauzi, oh iya, Aldi. Fauzi Ubaidillah, nothing. And Nurul Fauzia. So for Informatika only 4 ya. Only for students.
For student.
Wendy, Tegar, Aldi, sama Miss Nurul doang. Yang lain
mudik.
Already say goodbye kali. Okay, thank you very much guys. Have nice next class ya. PPKN. Semangat.
Ngelih,
mangan sih. Oke, okay, thank you very much semuanya. Sampai jumpa besok di conference. Sampai jumpa juga besok minggu depan. Kelompok 6 siapa aja tuh harus disiapkan dengan matang untuk presentasinya minggu depan. Karena itu adalah basic atau awal mula kita belajar bahasa Inggris. Kalau kita nggak paham terkait dengan present apa namanya tenses itu, maka nggak akan, maybe you cannot speak well in English. Your speaking will be amburadul.
Matok meletre.
Okay, so please prepare ya for the next presentation or I mean the last presentation. Thank you very much. Ya, yeah, Mr. Soleh ya minggu depan ya.
Siap, Pak. Insyaallah.
Kelihatan soalnya senyum-senyumnya. kelihatan soalnya.
Sama Mas Ridwan, Pak. Mas Ridwan.
Oke, sama Mas Ridwan sama-sama baju biru toh.
Pak Topan, Mas Topan. Hey.
Partai Pan.
Partai Pan. Podo karo kowe, Mas. Oke, thank you very much. Have a nice day. Have a nice class PPKN. Thank you very much. Nyalain kameranya dulu. Nyalain kamera sebentar.
Kacamatanya.
Gimana ya? Aku juga mau lah pakai.
Punya aku nggak bisa, Pak.
Ah.
Udah pakai kacamata ya, nggak usah.
Oke, okay, thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
See you. Terima kasih, Pak. Yo, sama-sama.
Terima kasih, Pak. Mari makan, marilah makan. Ayo, see you guys. See you everybody.